Hi, I'm Dr. Neil Ghodadra. We're doing an exciting surgery here on a patient of mine. He's a 71-year-old guy, and his diagnosis is early medial compartment arthritis.
I'm optimistic. I'm ready to move on with my life. I'm tired of not being able to walk.
So what we're doing here today is an exciting new technique. It's actually the first one ever done of its kind in LA. It's called a subchondroplasty. And the concept behind it is these patients that have early arthritis, they have bone marrow edema, which means kind of like a contusion in the bone right behind their cartilage defects. So what's interesting about that is what we're trying to do is using arthroscopy and using fluoroscopy, actually put a cannula into that defect and inject a biologic cement. The purpose of it then is to provide structural support for the bone and to allow your own growth factors to help grow new bone into that area. So the subchondroplasty device is on the knee. We're using fluoroscope to figure out exactly where we're going. So it's sitting right where we want it. So what we're gonna do now is we're actually gonna start injecting the cement into that area. So you can see how it's just a minimally invasive device, just a couple of pins, and no real incisions that need to be made.
So far, so good.
So we had the opportunity to see Fred again today. He's about a week now from having a subchondroplasty.
I haven't used crutches since the first day, and I'm limping around right now. It's somewhat painful, but it's getting better every day.
His wounds look great. He felt great. He's already walking and moving around, has full range of motion and no swelling in the knee.
I don't know what to actually plan on, but I'm hoping I'll be able to get back and hike and ride my bike.
So I told him, I said, you know, it'll take 4 to 6 more weeks for physical therapy and good recovery, but I expect him to get back to all his activities, including camping and hiking and fishing. And the nice thing about Fred is that he looks like and he's willing, ready, and able. And I think combined with the surgical effort and specifically his effort, I think he was going to have a perfect, full 100% recovery.
The people and staff at Lapeer were great. They recognized the fact that everybody's coming in there with some problems, and they're very sensitive, and I felt like everything was very smooth.